Hi, I'm Brent Curry, Web Marketing Specialist with Tiny Frog Technologies. Today I want to talk a little bit about Google Analytics and adding filters to your account so that you can filter out your own internal traffic from the data that you're viewing within your reports. So let's take a look.
So I want to show you how to add a filter to your Google Analytics data. Mainly this is helpful, or the most common ways I've seen it used is if you want to filter out your internal traffic. So you work within an office and you know what the IP address of that office is, or if you have specific referring sites that you want to stop coming in because it's skewing the information. But typically it's because you want to remove your own traffic. If you don't get a lot of traffic to your site, a couple hundred visitors a month, but you're on your site on a regular basis, your own traffic can really skew that data. So adding a filter basically filters that information out of the report. So in the admin section of your analytics account, go down to the third view, which is your actual web property. Click on filters here. And I'm going to add a filter, not for my office IP, but for our project management software. So anytime someone clicks on a link from our project management software that goes to a Tiny Frog page, it's someone internally working on a project or something of that nature. I just want to filter that out. So I'm going to add a filter, create a new filter, and we'll call it Project Management Tool. I'm going to exclude from the domain because this is actually a referring site. So I'm going to say that contains so that we get all versions, and we'll go podio.com, not case sensitive. And we'll save that. So now that's going to filter that out. If I wanted to do it by IP address, I could basically just say I want to exclude traffic from a specific IP address, get your IP address, fill it in these fields and save it, and that filters it out. So the one thing I want to caution you on the IP address is to remember that you added this filter, because if sometime down the road you create some new goals, some new conversion tracking, and you're testing it internally, it's never going to show up because you've filtered your own traffic out. So just keep that in mind. When you're testing things in the future, you may have to remove the filter and add it back.
Thank you for your time. I hope you enjoyed the topic today. If you have any questions about web marketing services or web marketing in general, please reach out to us. We'd be glad to assist.